वेलकम टू सविता डेंटल कॉलेज लेक्चर का सीरीज इन ऑर्थोडॉन्टिक्स। टुडेस टॉपिक इज केस हिस्ट्री इन ऑर्थोडॉन्टिक्स। फर्स्ट वी रिकॉर्ड द पर्सनल डिटेल्स ऑफ द पेशेंट, द नेम ऑफ द पेशेंट, दिस इज टू एड्रेस द पेशेंट, एज ऑफ द पेशेंट विच वी रिकॉर्ड इज योर क्रोनोलॉजिकल एज, इट कैन ऑल्सो बी स्केलेटल एज विच इज बेस्ड ऑन स्केलेटल मैच्योरेशन एंड डेंटल एज विच इज नथिंग बट योर डेंटल एरप्शन टाइमिंग्स। नेक्स्ट इज द सेक्स ऑफ द पेशेंट, ग्रोथ स्पॉट्स आर डिफरेंट इन द टू सेक्सेस, द टाइमिंग्स ऑफ ग्रोथ स्पॉट्स आर डिफरेंट, दैट्स वाई वी रिकॉर्ड द सेक्स ऑफ द पेशेंट। Address of the patient is recorded to communicate with the patient, and occupation is generally recorded to know the socio-economic status of the patient. Chief complaint is always recorded in the patient's own words. Medical history. Relevant medical history in orthodontics includes epilepsy. Now, epilepsy, as you all know, is nothing but seizures, and usually an orthodontic patient who is epileptic has to be taken care of. You need to delay treatment until it is controlled, and you need to take necessary precautions to prevent any further attack. Like you should avoid any bright lights, you should avoid a painful procedure. Rheumatic fever cases and cardiac patients may require antibiotic coverage. Diabetics under control can undergo treatment, and aspirin usage usually impedes orthodontic treatment. Now, special management is required for physical and mentally handicapped patients. Dental history taking is very important. You need to know the eruption status, history of trauma, and previous extractions done, and the previous orthodontic treatment is of very relevant importance. Now, the root resorption and bone loss is imperative in most of the orthodontically treated cases, so you need to know the previous history. Prenatal history, hypoplasia in fluoride exposure, staining in tetracycline injection cases is very common. Many drugs taken prenatally can cause cleft lip and palate, like aspirin, phenytoin, valproate. Hypoxia can also cause cleft lip and palate. Forceps delivery, which was common in the yesteryears, can cause trauma to the TMJ and even cause injuries to the TMJ. Postnatal history, we need to elicit the patient's type of feeding, which can either be bottle feeding or breastfeeding, milestones of development like crawling, walking, etc., and the various habits which are very commonly seen in children, like thumb sucking habit, mouth breathing habit, lip biting habit, etc. A typical thumb sucker will have proclined upper anteriors, retroclined lower anteriors, and anterior open bite. A mouth breather will have an adenoid facies, a long face, etc. Now, family history is also very important in orthodontics. Certain malocclusions are very commonly inherited, like class 3, which is common, which was very common in the Austrian royal family, and it is very famous as Habsburg jaw. Class 2 div 2 is very commonly inherited. The next is a general examination. We record the height and weight of the patient to know the growth status of the patient. The gait of the patient is nothing but the way he walks, and the posture is also very important. We also record the physique of the patient, whether he is aesthetic, plethoric, or he is athletic. The next is your body types. Sheldon classified body types into ectomorphic, mesomorphic, and endomorphic. This is based on the predominance of the germ layers. An ectomorphic individual usually has a lot of ectodermal derivatives. He is tall and thin. A mesomorph has more of mesodermal derivatives, and he is a nicely athletic patient. And an endomorph has more of endodermal tissues like fat and adipose tissues. Thank you.